Guys, I wanted to do a little book review here on Sepp Holzer's Permaculture. I got this a while back, I think for my birthday. It's taken me a while due to a lot of different work to be able to go through it. But I wanted to do a little book report on it. I haven't done book reports since I was a kid in school. So I hope I'm going to do okay with this. I'll start out with saying that I think Sepp Holzer's Permaculture is a good book to read, primarily because his emphasis all the way through it is paying attention to nature, always learning, to always learn from nature, observe. It is, to me, I feel, the biggest thing that I got out of this. It's a lot of other important items in there, but I mean, for me personally, that was the most important thing. He does have how-to things in here, but he always insists on you take the how-tos, but always pay attention because those how-tos may need to be adjusted and tweaked for different areas, different soils, or whatever. Sepp Holzer is a farmer of 60 years, maybe more. He's from Austria, somewhere near, I think, just south of Wien. Or some people call it Vienna. It's located in the High Alps. And he has created an environment that can grow even tropical plants. Has done very, very well. And he has even come under a lot of pressure and persecution from the Austrian government because he won't follow accepted techniques and methods. I believe he's also referred to as the renegade farmer in that area. In spite of the fact that his farm outproduces everybody, he still comes under attack. It's amazing. But there's a lot to learn in here. Sepp Holzer starts out with talking about his childhood and how he learned about nature and about gardening. He talks about his mistakes, and I think that's very, very important. You can learn from mistakes just as much, if not better, than from your successes. But his first section goes through landscape design, reading the land, and then, if necessary, remaking the land and excavating in certain areas. Now, for him, this is pretty much necessary because he's on the side of a mountain, guys. If you would like, look up on YouTube the Krameterhof. K-R-A-M-E-T-E-R-H-O-F. The Krameterhof. And see what he's got going there. It's very, very good. But first section is landscape design. The next section goes into alternative agriculture. Now, in some ways, Sepp Holzer was very much like Masanobu Fukuoka. They both were university trained. Even though Sepp Holzer grew up on a farm, family of farmers, he did go and study agriculture. Went back, started trying to put some into place, some of the new things he learned into place, and found that things were getting destroyed. Things were not producing as well. So he went back to his old natural ways. And this is what he's talking about with alternative agriculture. And this is where he's been getting a lot of persecution. He's had very heavy fines laid on him for stupid things such as not pruning his fruit trees the way they wanted him, and stupid things like that. But he also, and there's also alternative ways to keep livestock. Even a section on storing the food using natural cellars. That is a very interesting section. I really like that one. The next goes into fruit trees. How to cultivate them, how to propagate them. He has a section on grafting. Then the next section goes into mushrooms, how he cultivates mushrooms and the different types. That's something that I am also very highly interested in. Up to this point, the book deals primarily with farming. The next section goes into gardens, kitchen gardens, home gardens, and there's even a section in there on town gardens. And when I say town, I'm not talking about just urban gardening like we're seeing on YouTube where people got it in their backyard. I'm talking balcony to balcony on big condos and apartment buildings and stuff. His methods, the way he describes it to me, can be very easily, even though the first sections talk about large and mid-scale farming, they can easily be adjusted for small homes and town gardening. Very, very good book. I highly recommend it. As I said, it's got how-tos in it, but the most important thing, in my opinion, is the encouragement to constantly learn, to observe, and learn more about nature, and let nature tell you what it needs. Now, this is a point that I wanted to say, and I've been wanting to say, about what I am seeing happening with the permaculture movement right now. Bill Mollison, other people like Jeff Lawton, and others who are running around teaching them, they have broken permaculture down into mechanical process how-tos. And I think this is a very, very good thing. Because with it being broken down into mechanical processes, mechanical designs, and how-tos, it can get someone started much quicker. But what I am seeing is that as it trickles down and out and gets further away from its origins, people are beginning to accept the mechanical processes as an end and not an ongoing process. They're forgetting that they've got to continuously learn, that they've got to continuously pay attention to nature and learn from nature. Now, some may not really feel that way, but they're not saying it. And I think that it's important to say it, folks. Don't ever let it be forgotten. Because even if you're not saying it, and if you're not demonstrating it in what you're doing, eventually it will get to people and they will accept it as just a mechanical process, and it will begin to degrade. And in fact, I think it's already starting to degrade, and it really bothers me because I see permaculture as the answer to a lot of problems. Homesteaders, I don't think you guys have thought much about it, but you are sitting in a very, very key position where if you can learn to use permaculture processes, techniques, and methods, you can help return food production back to local farms. Now, there is the process of we're all going to have to fight the government and corporate rule to try to be able to bring it back. But this has that possibility. Well, guys, I hope you'll read this. I found it to be highly interesting. If nothing else, it's an enjoyable read. You guys have a good day.